students, so today we are going to discuss about the topic learners from diverse background. That is your first unit. So coming to the objectives of this unit one, the first objective is to identify the learners from diverse backgrounds, such as from marginalized groups, in terms of socioeconomic status, linguistic background, conflicting and war affected areas. The second objective is to explain their difficulties and their specific needs in school with respect to their learning characteristics. And lastly, the third objective is to describe specific strategies to meet out their needs in the schools. So coming to the definition, or we can say about the who are marginalized. So first one is lower caste or class. Second one is who are powerless. Third is who are poor. Fourth one is who are illiterate. Fifth one is gender bias or gender, we can say. And the last one is religious minority. Now coming to the types of deprived and marginalized learners. So marginalization at the individual level results in an individual's exclusion from meaningful participation in any type of society. So in the broader aspect, we can say about that deprived or marginalized groups have been identified as socially, politically, and economically backward learners. Now coming to the classroom situation or classroom scenario, the types of marginalized learners means mix up of different varieties of learners, and they are having with different cultural backgrounds. Then coming to the learners from different socio-economic backgrounds. The socio-economic status is the social standing or class of an individual or group. It is often measured as a combination of three important points, we can say. That is, first one is education, second is income, and third one is occupation. So learners from different family background, we can say about a child's learning starts from the family, and parents are the first teachers. So parents means both the father and mother. Both have an equal role in children's or child's learning. If one is absent, the role of both has to be played by the single parent. There are also different families suffering from different kinds of difficult situations, or we can say awkward situations, like addicted father beating up mother, or many other challenging situation can affect the socioeconomic background of a family. Now coming to the learners from different cultural and linguistic backgrounds. As we know about that, India is a very huge or vast country, and we are having so many types of multiple languages, culture, religion, and customs. The various castes and tribes with specific languages, mode, and culture and socio-cultural background we can see in our nation. Some learners come from different culture and various different type of linguistic backgrounds. So as per the Indian Constitution, we can say there are 23 languages are recognized. So one is English plus 22 are the other Indian languages, which includes Assamese, Bengali, Bodo, Dogri, Gujarati, Hindi, Kannada, Kashmiri, Konkani, Maithili, Malayalam, Maiti, Marathi, Nepali, Uriya, Punjabi, Sanskrit, Santhali, Sindhi, Tamil, Telugu, and Urdu. Among all these languages, Tamil and Sanskrit are the two official languages. So when we are coming to the classroom scenario or the classroom settings, there are students from various backgrounds, and which makes a heterogeneous group. All these combinations if we see in a particular type of classroom setting or a scenario. So definitely they will be having different needs, which has to be looked by the different types of teachers or different settings. So coming to the learners from conflicting and war affected areas. So as we know that in all over the world, there are, the world is going to unrest. Various insurgencies and wars can be seen in various countries, and various terrorism activities also been in increase. So one of the more problem or the area of concern is refugee infiltrations from neighboring countries. Children from such families feel insecure in different manners. For example, definitely economically, socially, and culturally. In most cases, they do not have sufficient opportunity for their basic education. So even when they do not get an opportunity, they feel left out or rejected due to non-acceptance by mainstream society, school, and definitely when both these things are happening, so peer group also, they are uncomfortable. So at times they do not get the opportunity to go to the school as they have to earn for their existence as child labor. So they are bound to be a child labor. So coming to the most significant area, that is barriers to the education of deprived and marginalized learners. So basically three areas we have to be more specific and concerned, as they have many obstacles. So three obstacles we are going to discuss here. So first one, the most important one, is the community. So barriers due to physical and social environment, economic constraints, lack of parental involvement, and community participation. Sometimes learners are compelled to participate in community decided activities, as we have already discussed, like child labor, and one of the most important obstacle which we can see in our scenario is child marriage, and many other factors are all also present. The second one is school and education system. Proper school is definitely required. Trained teachers are definitely required. Flexible system of education is one of the prior area which is not available in many places of India in our nation. There is also lack of gender-friendly school environment. The third one, again one of the most important factor, is poverty level. The challenge of poverty associated with various types of disabilities is the major barrier for deprived and marginalized learners. So in this video, we have discussed about many types of barriers and other meaning of marginalization. Thank you.